Hi, today we will see about the application of Ampere's circuit law. So under the application of Ampere's circuit law, we are going to see about the coaxial cable. So you are well known about the coaxial cable. The coaxial cable is a probe what you use in our lab. So it has an inner conductor which carries the positive current and the outer conductor which carries the negative current. And in between the inner conductor and the outer conductor, we have a dielectric material. So, we are taking the radius of the inner conductor as A and the radius starting of your outer conductor is taken as B, and between A and B we have the dielectric material. The thickness of the inner outer conductor is B to C. So, inner conductor is radius A carrying current I. The outer conductor having the radius B starts with the radius B. And the outer radius is C. It carries the current minus I. Okay. Again, we are to do the calculation, we are assuming that cable is placed along the z-axis. So, in the coaxial cable, we have four regions. One is within the inner conductor when R is considered less than A. So, R is the radius of the Ampere path. So, R is less than A. In region 2, the radius of the Ampere path is between A and B. Region 3, it is in the within the outer conductor. So, radius of the Ampere path R is between B and C. Region 4 is outside the cable. So, let's see about the region 1. So, region 1 is inner conductor R is less than A. So, we will take a closed path having the radius R, that is the Ampere path, and the cross-sectional area of the Ampere path is pi r square. The total current is I. The area of the total inner conductor will be pi a square. So the current enclosed by the closed path is I dash. So current enclosed by the closed path will be equal to total current will come in the denominator and the current of the Ampere path will come in the numerator. Okay, so that will be pi r square divided by pi a square into I. So, how I dash will be the total current enclosed by the closed path will be the, we are dividing the areas, pi r square divided by pi a square into I, cancel the pi, you will get r square by a square into I. Okay, now by the Ampere's circuit law, it is the line integration of h dot dl is equal to I. So, we have to know H, DL and I. First, we have calculated I. Second, we will calculate the H vector. So, H vector is along the A phi direction. So, H phi into A phi. DL is along the A phi direction alone. So, R into D phi into A phi. So, multiply H dot DL. H dot DL will be H phi into A phi, R dot D phi into A phi. A phi dot A phi is equal to 1. So, you will get H phi R D phi. Now substitute in the Ampere circuit law. So if you substitute in the Ampere circuit law, you will get the value of H vector dot DL vector H phi R into A phi. Substitute the value of I dash R square by A square into I. Now integration D phi, the limit will be from 0 to 2 pi, the full cylinder. Again, if you integrate D phi, it is phi. So, if you upper limit minus lower limit means 2 pi minus 0. So, H phi will be equal to R square by 2 pi R A square into I. Now, cancel the R in the numerator and denominator. You will get R by 2 pi A square into I. So, therefore, the magnetic field intensity inside the inner conductor will be I R 2 pi A square into A phi. Okay. So, next we will see about the region 2. The region 2, if you see, that is the inner conductor, full inner, outside the inner conductor. When you see outside the inner conductor, it is similar to the current carrying magnetic field intensity of a straight conductor along the z-axis. So, as you know, we derived in the previous thing. So, for straight conductor, the equation is H vector is equal to I by 2 pi R into A phi. So, this is for the region 2. So, region 3, it is within the outer conductor. So, it is between B and C. So we know that the outer conductor carries the current minus I, one thing. So cross-sectional area of ambient path will be pi into r square minus b. The cross-sectional area of the full inner conductor will be pi c square minus b square. So the current will be I dash will be equal to, as we done in the region 1. So area of the total area in the denominator and the ambient path area in the numerator into current. So pi into r square minus b divided by pi into c square minus b square into minus I. Cancel the pi, you will get minus r square minus b square by c square minus b square into I. Now I double dash will be equal to I, the current in inner conductor. So the total current enclosed by the closed path, that is in the outer conductor, will be inner conductor current plus I dash. So inner conductor current will be I. So substitute here, then we have to simplify this equation. So to simplify the equation, cross multiply. So you will get, first take I commonly outside, you will get 1 minus r square minus b square by c square minus b. Now cross multiply. What will b square minus b square minus b square? So you will get a plus b square, so that will get cancelled. So you will get c square minus r square by c square minus b square. Okay, this is for the total current. Now we can go with the Ampere circuit law. Ampere circuit law is H vector dot dl is equal to I. So substitute the value of H vector. H vector is H phi into A phi. dl is R into D phi into A phi. H dot dl will be equal to H phi R D phi. Same as the region 1. Substitute here. So next substitute the value of phi enclosed. Again in the integral, phi alone is the component. So upper limit minus lower limit 2 pi minus 0, it is 2 pi. H phi R into 2 pi is equal to I into C square minus R square by C square minus B square. Now H phi is equal to, take other terms to the RHS. So it 1 by 2 pi R C square minus R square by C square minus B square. So what is H is equal to H phi into A phi? So 1 by 2 pi r c square minus r square by c square minus b square into a phi vector. So this is for the region 3. Now for region 4, it is outside the conductor. The outside the current conductor, what is the total current? Plus I minus I. So plus I minus I, that is 0. So total current is 0. So by Ampere's circuit law, H dot dl is equal to 0. So H dot dl is equal to 0 means H vector is equal to 0. So thus far we have found for the all four regions of the coaxial cable. Again, for the region 4, there is no magnetic field exists outside the cable. Now we will have a graphical representation of relations between magnetic field intensity in all four regions. So in region 1, H vector is equal to I by R 2 pi A square into A phi vector. H is directly proportional to R. So directly proportional to R means it will increase linearly. So in this graph you can see that it is increasing linearly. Okay, so it is directly proportional to R. In the region 2, what is the value of H? I by 2 pi R A phi vector. In this, H is inversely proportional to R, 1 by R. So what will happen? So H is proportional to 1 by R means it will start to reduce. So till B it will start to reduce. So in region 3, it is between B and C. What is the value? 1 by 2 pi R C square minus R square by C square minus B square. Here, R is only the variable. 1 R square and here 1 R square. Again, it is approximately a decreasing value till 0. When you substitute C instead of R, what will happen? C square minus C square is 0. So when R is equal to C, it is 0. When R is equal to B, C square minus B square will get cancelled. It is I by 2 pi R. So again, it is a decreasing component. So it will at C, the value of magnetic field intensity will be 0. So this is for region 3. So region 4, it's very easy. H is equal to 0. So we can maintain H is equal to 0. So this is the graphical representation of magnetic field intensity for a coaxial cable. So remember the steps. Always you are going to apply the Ampere circuit law. H dot dl is equal to I. First you have to find I, H vector, dl vector. Substituting Ampere circuit law, you will get the equation. Thank you. Meet you in the next video.